Right, my second GoPro 9 battery's just gone, so I've stopped dead just as I'm going to go through this spring-loaded gate and put a new battery in. So this one will give us an hour and a half or whatever, because it's fully charged up, and that's enough to get us back to the car, hopefully. Then I won't need to change batteries again yet. Right, this is a bloody awkward one to get in, because it's high. The spring-loaded gate is, you've got to push it open, try and step up at the same time. Ow, hit your knees off the bloody rocks. Ah, man. Oh, God's sake, man. I hate that gate. Right, so they've come through this gate and they've headed across the, over there to that abandoned barn that I took pictures of earlier on. Right, there's a dog walker coming along with his dog. Aye, aye. Has the dog done a runner or something?
Sorry?
Has the dog done a runner?
No, we're on a trail.
All right, okay.
Where the chalk trail.
Oh, it's you that's dropping the chalk all over.
Yeah.
All right.
You've been down that way, seen chalk?
I've been right to...
It's all flowers.
Whitfield Force over there.
Uh-huh.
Millgill Force, Whitfield Force. And you've got to go down by the edge of the beck and just go along the bottom to get to Whitfield Force waterfall. But it's a hell of a journey scrambling along, especially for me because I've had heart attacks and stroke and I haven't got used to my left arm. But I've done it, so, and then I'm going back home.
You've seen bobs of flour, have you?
Got there's one where you go through, there's an arrow, but most of them are just circles of white flour.
Yeah, right, great.
And you see where they've got it out of the pocket.
Well, that means we know we don't have to go that way now, you see.
All right. So where you go, you're just following the path where there's chalk marks. Great. Right, so where have I just go through that gate there? Just go straight ahead through the next gate and then the next gate.
Great stuff.
And just keep heading towards Whitfield Force waterfall.
Right.
Yeah.
Good.
Aye, because there's a few. All right. There's a few of them that are on the path.
Oh yeah, there will be.
Yeah.
It's
lovely. Thank God we're getting an episode from the rain. Morning.
Good morning.
Morning. Are you following that trail with all the white flour dropped down?
We
all right.
Indeed.
Just keep going up there and just go through the gate on the right then. Keep going through the next one. Head towards Whitfield Force. That's where all the chalk marks are. Yeah. Morning. Funny how you get different people with different attitudes. Everyone that's walked past me so far said morning or hello. This miserable bugger here didn't say a word. Must be part of a walking club because there's quite a few of them coming up here following the chalk mark signs. Morning.
Good morning.
Right. I'll let you get past. My balance is crap, so it takes me ages.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
Thank you.
Love you then.
Morning.
Hiya.
What walking club are you with?
It's Loon Valley Hush House Harriers.
All right,
it's
Loon Valley.
Supposed to be running, really.
You cannot,
some people are.
I would like to be running on this and slipping on the roots. Looks like, are you going in the wrong direction? It's that way you want to be towards Whitfield Force. I'm saying they're going to the wrong. Are you following the chalk marks that they've dropped down for the path? is that where you want to be?
Yes.
Yeah, where
okay.
The chalk marks are.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right.
I've just passed the two guys that were putting the chalk marks down.
Yeah.
Keep heading up there to the.
We know where we finish.
Just got to look for the round chalk marks that they've dropped chalk. Come up this way, go right up there. To the top wall, go through the spring-loaded gate, then go through the next one, and then the next one. Just keep the beck to your right, and you can't go wrong. Just head for.
We're only going as far as Whitfield.
All right. Well, Whitfield Force is up that direction.
Yeah.
That's where I've just been. Yeah.
I've been before many years.
I've been here many, many, many times.
Lovely.
I live in South Shields, but I love to come back here.
Lovely. Isn't
it? Lovely. Well, I hope you enjoy your day. See if people are not seeing this wooden mark I put us here because it's slightly hidden by the trees here hanging over. They've gone into the wrong waterfall, heading in the wrong direction. But this going back down here goes around the corner where the stairs take up and the water comes through the farmer's field through the bottom of the well. Right, here's the stairs that you go up again. When it's been raining heavy day after day after day, there's loads of water come seeping through the bottom of this well, and this path is flooded, and it gives a powerful stream going all the way down there. A 70 foot down to the beck down there, look. Right, back up the stairs again. I'll have to answer which walking club you're with. Loon, such, Harriers. But we're supposed to be running. So once again, those people that were just passed again, friendly, talk, chat, say good morning. But that guy on his own, miserable git. That's what I call them when they're like that. It's the kind of people that probably live on their own and they just live a miserable existence. A miserable person. And that's why they're on their own. There's nobody can put up with them. With a bad attitude. Right, so there's the first one that I noticed across the white powder. Right, so I've got to go right back along here, go through the two gates and turn left and go over the little concrete bridge with the metal railings, handrails. And then back under the water race and then cut across the flagstone path to the other side and then walk back along the lane to the church. Then I'll be back in the car. Like I say, it's not a long distance walk, but there's just loads to see. It's beautiful in such a short distance. And the views that you get on one side over the valley, over the moors and that, one side, and then you've got the ravine with the river down on the other side. It's just a stunning walk. And now that the sun's come out as well, it makes it more pleasant again. Like somebody else coming along there now. So I hope that guy that passes us a miserable git, if somebody points out and sees that, recognise him on the video, just say, look. Morning. Just talking about miserable gits, and some people talk to you and some don't. And that young woman there, or young girl, totally miserable as well. I mean, she had half an excuse. She had a jacket in her teeth pulling the zip down, but she still could have stopped what she was doing just to say, hi, good morning, hello, anything, just to acknowledge you. But no, nothing. It's like the other thing that annoys me is when I'm driving and if you pull over and let people pass you and you lift your hand up to wave and say thank you, or pulling over and letting us pass when they don't acknowledge what you've done for them. Hello, son. Hello. Hello, son. Hello. Here you are. Here you are. Here you are. Good boy. Here you are. Come on in.
Hi.
Hiya.
How are we doing?
Are you on this Luna Harrier's run or something? On the path?
Oh, no, we're just going for a wander for tonight. Right. So I've no idea where it actually goes. So.
Whitfield Force? Is that where you're going?
Yes,
Millgill Force, that's then the one. Whitfield Force.
That's
second.
It.
Now, yeah. People make the mistake when you go to try and get a Whitfield Force. You get to a fork in the path where there's a dead tree that's been, looks like it's been hit by lightning. Once you pass that, and you come to the fork, the left-hand side takes you along the top, continue along the wall sort of thing in the wire fence.
Right.
But you can't see the waterfall from the top through the tree. So
Right. What
you've got to do, it's more difficult, but you go down the bottom path to the right. Then you scramble over a big tree where it's fallen over, or the roots are up in the air. It's all mud and slush at the bottom. But if you bypass that and go along the planks that people have put down, and then just scramble along the edge of the beck and get to the waterfall at the far side.
Thanks very much, pal.
Stunning.
Hello.
Thank you.
Hiya.
Thank you.
Enjoy your day anyway.
Thank you.
Trying to help people out as much as I can. Oh, that reminds me, and all, some, I swear, like some friggin' idiot left a comment on my YouTube channel of one of my videos that said, oh, why do you always stop and ask people for the time just so you can stand talking to them and give them the benefit of your advice, you know, for the walks? So I just answered them. I says, well, for first of all, I don't wear a watch. Second of all, I don't carry a mobile phone, so I don't know what time it is. And third of all, I've got no intention of just stopping people for the time just so I can give them the benefit of my knowledge of doing the walks. It's because I want to know what time it is. So if it's anywhere near lunchtime, I can stop at one of my favourite stop-off points for a picnic and have my lunch break. And of course, I never got any reply back, but what a stupid effing question. Of course, obviously, he's a troll. This person that asked the question, because you look at their videos, there's nothing on their video channels. They're just a troll. Right, I'll let you pass.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. That's lovely day for a change. Get up while it stops raining.
I won't come around today, I don't think.
All right.
Yeah.
Right. There you are, just stop, let people pass. Oh, thanks very much, cheers, blah, blah, blah. Pleasant smiles on their faces. Time to stop and talk to you, or even acknowledge you, that you exist. What a big difference. I mean, obviously I'm a chatty person anyway. I talk to people, it doesn't bother me. I like to be pleasant. Use manners, please and thank yous. That's the way I've been brought up. So I'm never ever going to stop being pleasant and talking to people just because some arsehole comes on me channel and says, why do you stop and ask, you know, all the time? All the time. Stupid bastard. They must be sad. Well, I don't like to swear a lot. Fuckers. Right, another dog water. Morning. Come on, I'll let you pass. How is son? Are you going to come and say hello? Come on. I love dogs. I've had dogs all my life. Hey, come on. You'll probably smell my dog. Come on. Hey, hey. A little bit cautious. Are you going to Whitfield Force or Millgill Force?
I don't really know where we're going. We've
right.
Set off.
All right.
We won't go too far because he's old and arthritic. So.
Right. It's not that far. That's the good beauty of this walk. Millgill Force.
Far, but I can't remember it. So.
Right. Well, you just keep on. You follow the wall all the way along. You go through several like spring-loaded gates.
Yeah.
And basically, at the end of the day, if you keep paddock back to your right. When you're going along, you kind of go wrong. And then look for the wooden marker posts for little step-ups that you do to go if there's a fork in the path. And there's one goes down to the first waterfall on a bit of a slope going down. And then you come back up from that. And then on the right-hand side, there's a marker post where the path goes up off to the left. And that's what takes you forward again to Whitfield Force. It'll probably come back to you when you
It'll come back to you when you
see it.
We didn't have an old dog last time.
All right. Oh, so you're not on about your partner?
Sorry?
You're not on about your partner? Morning.
Hello, you all right?
Hello.
Hello. Right. So we're getting towards, well, it's getting later on in the day now, so we've got more and more people coming to do this walk because it's very, very, very popular. Because, like I say, it's such a short walk. It's not too difficult. And you see lots of water features along its length of the pathway. Right, back down the bottom here and through two gates, turn left, and then I'm back at the mill race, the water race, metal trough, and go underneath it. Right, this is the time to stop and take views. Right, so that's the outdoor centre that you pass when you drive out of Askrig and you come round past that, and that's where Paddock Beck bends round and starts going over to the wall over there beyond that. And if you drive further up the road and then you get to the point where you turn left and cross over the bridge going into Bainbridge, that's the area that I'm at as you pass through Askrig. I'm surprised that I remember the name when I was trying to remember the name of the beck down below. It only took a few seconds to come into my brain, which is good for me. Paddock Beck. Unusual name, paddock. It's like a horse in the paddocks. So I'll just keep pointing my camera over the wall. And like I say, it's typical of Yorkshire. It's dotted with all these barns. Like I say, they're about 50 foot square and two levels high. Morning.
Morning.
Nice day for a pleasant walk.
Gorgeous,
up to Whitfield Force.
Yeah.
It's running in full speed at the minute. It's lovely.
Is it?
Yeah. Right, nearly back now. So drop down this bit hill and through the first spring-loaded gate, then drop down 50 yards, then through the next one on the left, which takes you down the bridge, down the steps. right, with uploading these videos and all on my older machine that I haven't used for ages, which I'm using now because my main machine's in the computer shop. It takes us longer to upload the videos after rendering them and making them into YouTube videos. So I just normally set them up, set them away, let it do its thing to change it into a video that I can upload onto my YouTube channel, then go and make myself a cuppa or something like that and just float around looking on my eBay channels and stuff like that, or my YouTube channel itself, to see what videos that I've done before, blah blah blah, just to kill time while I'm waiting for the video to be finished so I can upload it onto my YouTube channel. So my YouTube channel is called Sand Dancer Sentinel. Right, here's the first of the two gears that you go through. Right, down these steps. So just a reminder, people like you, you're out walking with the Sand Dancer Sentinel. And today's date is Sunday the 5th of November. So obviously I had all the fireworks gone off last night till early hours in the morning, and I didn't get a good sleep. So by the time I get home and go to bed tonight, I'll sleep like a log, because I'll be tired after the walk and then yeah, driving home and stuff like that. It takes it with you, especially when you're getting older. Now once again, as you come through this gate here, you can see a path cut in going over in that direction, going back over towards where you drive past out of Askerig and go towards where you turn left on the bridge to go to Bainbridge. But that could be just where sheep have walked across the fields, not a public footpath for hikers. I don't know. Right through this gate and down over the bridge again. I don't know why, but when I get to this bit here, I'm always reminded of the corn coming across here and racing ahead of me and standing here waiting for me to open that gate so it can continue. Dead excited, knowing he's going out and running about. Right, so, like I say, when it's been raining heavy, this whole part of the river is full, and you can't see all these boulders, and it comes, tear ass and run this corner, goes underneath the bridge, and that place there, that looks like deep enough and, you know, long enough to get a long, good swim here, just underneath the bridge. So, all your wild swimmers, if you watch this video, good place to go and have a swim. On the Paddock Beck from Askerig. Right.